of Drake's World. As always, I am your host, Damian Drake, and today we are going to be doing a spoiler-free movie review. I repeat, a spoiler-free. I will be doing another version of this where I will be talking about all the spoilers, and for the movie we are going to be doing a spoiler-free review on is The Flash. I recently saw this last week, by the time you guys are watching this video, and I have to say I thoroughly enjoyed it without really going into detail about anything. I will say the hype around it that, you know, everyone's like, oh, it's the greatest superhero movie of all time and, you know, all that. I wouldn't say it's not the greatest superhero movie of all time, but it's definitely a great superhero film. Again, without going into detail, like, it really does, I would say it's probably what a Flash movie should be. You know, for all of you that know the backstory of the Flash and pretty much his general motive a lot, you know, for what the backstory is, again, I'm trying not to go into too details about this movie because I definitely recommend people watching it if interested. I know there's probably going to be a lot of people that aren't interested in seeing it, especially the controversy around Ezra Miller. But honestly, if you can get past what they did and for what they done, it really does. Man, it's so hard to talk about this stuff without spoiling stuff. It really does go on a roller coaster of emotions. It's funny, it's sad, it's serious, it can be a little dark, it can also be very uplifting, and I came out enjoying it, especially for all the surprises that happen in the film, all the special cameos, I will say, that we do get to see. Another thing that was a lot of issues for people were the special effects, CGI. Now, I can understand why a lot of people had issues with the CGI, and a lot of people even said the CGI takes them out of the film, like it takes them out of the story of what's going on. It didn't really do that for me. Again, I really try not to have that stuff kind of ruin my movie experience when it comes into watching these, you know, big action-packed superhero movies or any type of movies that have a bunch of CGI in it. I will say the CGI is a little cheesy, but I don't really want to say it's cheesy, you know. But I think also, too, people have to realize with a character like this, there's going to be, like, layers and layers and layers of CGI, so, you know, as much as of a fan of practical effects like I am, you know, with a character like this, you really can't do practical effects as good, because honestly, it's probably not going to be as great as it looks for especially a character like The Flash and for his, for The Flash's film. But, another thing too, a lot of people said, like, the third act of the film was kind of, like, rushed and, you know, jumps all over the place and all that stuff. For me, I didn't really see that at all. And again, I'm trying to explain as best as I can without going into spoiler territory, at least yet. So, but yeah, like, I don't know. I'd probably say for me, the film was very satisfying. I enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun watching it. I definitely would go see it again, and, you know, I definitely would recommend it for people who are interested in seeing it. And, you know, for those who don't really know what the film is about or, you know, what it kind of deals with, obviously, like, time travel is a big part of it. It's there in the trailers. I will say I recommend for people who don't understand what's going on or, you know, aren't going to quite get it, I recommend if you look up the Flashpoint Paradox storyline for The Flash. That's like a big inspiration for this film, and it's there. It's there in the movie. They do play with some things very differently. They don't really take from that particular storyline and, you know, comic and all that. It really kind of does its own thing. but it's, I definitely would say it's very fan service, and it is, it's a big roller coaster. It's, but it's a fun roller coaster. I know some people watch those type of movies and then after the film they're like, oh my god, what did I just watch? Again, that wasn't me when I watched it. Then again, I'm somewhat of an easy pleaser when it comes to movies, but I mean, like, I do have my issues with it, but I mean, I can look past the issues. Like, I don't really think the issues that I have with it are gonna take my fun out of the movie. You know, I do say, like, I probably would say the one of the issues I have, and this is kind of a thing for everybody, is I would say the young Barry Allen, which is the Barry, which is, like, again, it's hard to kind of explain it, but there's two versions of Barry Allen. There's the Ezra Miller Barry Allen that we know from, you know, the Justice League movie, and that, and then there's a younger version of Barry Allen, which is who he encounters with when he goes back in time and comes back from time travel. That version of Barry is very annoying and, you know, kind of and very jittery and all that stuff. But again, like, that's, I think that was kind of a joke to kind of how he was played as in the Joss Whedon Justice League, which is not the Zack Snyder version of Justice League. There is two different versions of the Justice League movie. If you don't know the whole story, it's a whole big thing. You can literally watch a YouTube video about it. But yeah, like, so, but I don't have an issue with it. It didn't take my fun out of the movie, but it's kind of annoying and a lot at first, but you can look past it. And then there's moments where when you see two versions of the Barry together and just, you know, it's played by the same person, so you literally have to put the person's face on a different body so it looks like they're the same people and they're on the same screen. And sometimes the CGI for that just wasn't really that well done. There's moments where it's not that noticeable, but then there's other moments where it's really noticeable and you're kind of like, oh, okay. So but my likes about it is the story. The main thing of the story is he tries to save his mom. And again, if you guys know the story of The Flash, then you know. If for those of you who don't know, when Barry Allen was about 10 or 11 years old, he lost his mom and his dad as well. But his dad was blamed for the death of his mom. And then it kind of puts him in this whole, you know, thing of like, oh, I'm going to do everything I can to help my dad and prove his innocence. So that's kind of the basis of his superhero origins. A little bit more to it, but that's kind of like the full basis. That's probably as best as I can talk about it and give my review on it without, again, going into spoiler territory, which I will be doing another video on while I will be going into spoilers. There's multiple villains in the film too, and a lot of surprises. Again, it's just one big roller coaster of emotions, which I think is good because a lot of superhero films don't really have those emotions. You know, they don't really have a lot of those emotions, and, you know, they kind of really have more of like a standard of like what they want to do. But for The Flash, it really plays into like the funny, serious, dark, happy and all that stuff, which is what I really enjoyed. So yeah, that's my review, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you guys had fun listening to me just go on a tangent about superheroes and the film. Again, I will be doing another video on The Flash, but with more spoiler talk and everything. For posting on my videos, I will be trying to do these very kind of like bi-weekly, sometimes weekly. It just really depends. Obviously, I'm very busy for a lot of you that know. So, again, thank you guys so much for watching, and please give it a thumbs up for a like, please subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon.